Hello students, in this video we are going to study about the hydropower station. So what is the hydropower station? It is also called as the hydroelectric power station, which is a major renewable energy source used all over the world today to produce electricity. It utilizes the basic law of physics, that is the falling of water under high pressure as high as the kinetic energy. In this HEP station, the falling water turns the turbines, and through the magnetic induction, the generator converts the mechanical energy of turbines to electricity. The technique of using the dam water falling from a height to turn the turbines of the generator is the principle. So the mechanical energy is converted into the electric form and fed into the national grid system. The location of the hydroelectric power station must be analyzed by an expert to determine the effective head for the maximum efficiency. The hydraulic systems are also used to utilize the concept on slower and slow-moving water streams. One advantage is that the water is available for other use after the generation. A river with high water flow and head is a better source of hydropower. Now we will see the components of hydropower station. The first is the dam that creates the water head. The water falls from the base of the dam at high velocity and provides kinetic energy to turn the turbines. The second component is the reservoir. The water reservoir is placed behind the dam where the water is stored and is located higher than the rest of the dam structure. The height of the water in the reservoir decides how much potential energy the water possesses. The higher the height, more is the potential energy. The third component is the electric plant, where the electricity is produced and connected to the grid. Now we will see the working. The hydroelectric power comes from the water at work, where the water is in motion. It means that it is a form of a solar energy, as the sun gives the power in the hydrologic cycle. What do you know about the hydrologic cycle? In that, the atmospheric water reaches the earth's surface as a form of precipitation. Some of the water evaporates, but much of it percolates or becomes the surface runoff. Water from the rain and the melting snow eventually reaches the ponds, lake reservoirs, where evaporation is constantly occurring. So the same mechanism goes here of the hydrologic cycle, and the water cycle is being completed when the same water vapor passes into the atmosphere by evaporation, and then again it circulates, condenses into clouds, and in the form of rain it returns to earth. Thus the water cycle is complete. So the same goes for the hydropower station. The water is a renewable resource. That's why the water is very much important for the working of hydropower station. Now we will see the power generation. In generating electricity, no new energy is created, but one form of energy is converted to another form. To generate electricity, water must be in motion, that is the kinetic energy. When the flowing water turns the blade in turbine form, it changes into the mechanical energy. This turbine turns the generator and rotor, which then converts this mechanical energy into another form, that is the electricity. That's why this is called as the hydroelectric power or hydropower, where water is the initial source of energy. Some power plants are located on rivers, streams and canals, but for a reliable water supply, dams are needed. Dams store water for later release for such purposes as irrigation, domestic and industrial use, and power generation. This reservoir, which is placed behind the dam, acts much like a battery, storing water to be released as needed to generate power. The dam creates a head or a height from which the water flows. The pipe, that is the penstock, carries the water from the reservoir to the turbine. The fast moving Fast moving water pushes the turbine blade, something like a pinwheel, in the wind. The water force on the turbine blade turns the rotor and moving the part of the electric generator, and thus the electricity is produced. Now, how the power is being computed? So, it is important to remember that people and all before a hydroelectric power site is developed, engineers compute how much power can be produced when the facility is being completed. The actual output of the energy at a dam is determined by the volume of water which is released and the vertical distance of the waterfall. So, a given amount of water falling a given distance will produce a certain amount of energy. The head and the discharge at the power site and the desired rotational speed of the generator determine the type of turbine to be used. The head produces the pressure, and the greater the head, the greater pressure to drive the turbines. Here, the pressure is being measured in PSI. Now, we will see what types of turbines are used in the hydropower plant. So, the impulse and the reactions type of turbines are being used. So, it is not being specific that what type of turbines can be used on the hydropower plant. So, the turbine selection depends largely on the site conditions. Now, we will see the reaction turbine. It is a horizontal or vertical wheel that operates with the wheel completely submerged in the water, which reduces the turbulence. It works like a rotating lawn sprinkler, where the water at the central point is under pressure and escapes from the end of the blades, which causes the rotation. This impulse turbine. An impulse turbine is a horizontal or vertical wheel that uses the kinetic energy of water striking its buckets or blades to cause the rotation. The wheel is covered by a housing and a bucket or blades that are shaped so that turn the flow of water about 170 degrees inside the housing. After turning the blades, the water falls to the bottom of the wheel housing and flows out. So, this is the impulse turbine. Importance of hydropower. It is important to remember that the people, all their actions are the part of the natural world. So, the material used for the building, energy, clothing, food, and all the parts of our day-to-day world come from the natural resources. Our surroundings are composed largely of a built environment which has structures and facilities that are built by humans for getting comfort, security, and well-being. So, as our built environment grows, we grow more reliant on its offerings. To meet our needs and support our built environment, we need electricity which can be generated by using the resources of natural fuels. Most resources are not renewable, but there is a limited supply. We know that any innovation introduced by the people has an impact on natural environment. That impact may be desirable to some and at the same time unacceptable to the others. So, using any source of energy has some environmental cost. Degree of impact on the environment, that is crucial. So, this was all about the hydropower station or the hydropower plant, which is used to generate the electricity with the source, that is water. Thank you.